Good dark morning to our dark listeners.
Bad evening, Bizarro.
Gabriel's just spouting random words now. I'm Yahtzee Croshaw, and we're keeping a threat that we made last week.
Let's
drown out a whole game for once.
Let's do a whole thing.
But there was actually quite a lot of demand for us to play Dark Souls, since we go on about it or not.
Mm.
But I decided we were going to do Dark Souls 2. Why is that?
Because I've played Dark Souls 1, you've played Dark Souls 2, but I haven't played Dark Souls 2. So we get the joy of a knowing player and a noob. And we're going to go death for death, which I think is a classic way of sharing a single player experience.
Yes.
From the olden times.
Although I have a feeling most of the death is going to be on Gabriel's side of things.
Yeah, I haven't started. Dark Souls is a lot like a full-on relationship for me. Like, I lost the save to my old Dark Souls, and that kind of broke my heart. And I didn't get to... I've only just sort of started playing Dark Souls 1 again.
Oh, I just realized we've been pronouncing it wrong this whole time. Oh. It's Dark Souls.
Oh, okay.
Dark. Just remember always to pronounce it properly.
Dark Souls.
So, how Dark Souls 2 differs from Dark Souls 1, first of all, is that Dark Souls 1 starts with like a big,
universe setting.
Yeah, intro video to the universe saying, this is what has happened in the universe so far.
Mm-hmm.
All of these crazy gods and heroes you're going to fucking murder later on. Dark Souls 2 just basically starts with you. It says, you are a lone wanderer, you've gotten a nasty case of undeath.
Yeah, that's...
You're forgetting...
That's going around.
You are forgetting your former life.
Aww.
And now you're going to the mystical kingdom of Drangleich to hopefully find a solution. That's all we know going in. And
okay.
We have this rather long-winded intro establishing all that.
It looks almost like FMB.
All of this basically doesn't matter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's just the steps you took to get to where you are at the start of the game, and it doesn't really matter that much. But here's a melty-faced lady.
Oh, my butter wife. Melting.
Show off how good we are at CG and shit.
That's why you don't make a wife out of butter.
Well, no.
It's a foolish act.
I mean, the sex is great for a while. But
yeah, it starts
summer,
out good.
Summer comes around. Takes ages to get the grease stain off the bathroom floor. In retrospect, probably shouldn't have showered with her. Yes, here's an old lady.
A crone! With wizard eyes.
Yes. Telling us about a kingdom.
Made of skulls and shit.
Look, it's not Anor Londo. And there's dragons.
So is this... Like, does this connect directly to the original in any way, shape, or form?
Well, that's the thing.
Okay.
It's all up in the air, really.
So it's one
Although
of
I have watched a lot of Vartividia's excellent Dark Souls plot explanation videos on his YouTube channel, which I can recommend. I guess the general accepted theory is that Dark Souls 2 takes place sometime after Dark Souls 1, like millennia after.
Okay.
Or maybe not that long.
All right. Or not.
It's possible we're in the same like world, the same lands as Dark Souls 1, but all the kingdoms have changed names and fallen to ruin several times over since then.
Ah, that old chestnut.
Yes, indeed. So, yeah, as with all Souls games, our character is a total blank slate. But I figured if you want to get into games like these, you have to sort of meet it halfway. So we're going to come up with a role-play character that we're going to be.
Doug Slate.
No, that's a bad name.
That's an awesome name.
We're going to figure out exactly the circumstances of his life before he got to this point so that everyone can be all, you know, sympathetic to his struggles.
He was a door-to-door shawl salesman.
Well, that might explain a few things because he's wearing about 15 of them.
Yeah, well, yeah, see, there you go. And he got fired for stealing stock. It was a great moment of shame for him.
Yeah, no, I think he's a bath mat seller. He sells the mats that go around baths and toilets.
Around or the ones you stand on?
But he always dreamed of a more adventurous life. And now this has been thrust upon him by his mysterious undeath.
Yeah, so it's like...
Now he's going to jump down this whirlpool. You know, maybe we should rethink this, Doug. I mean, maybe we should go back and try another go at the whole bath mat. Okay, never mind.
Suicide is painless.
This place could really use a bath mat, he thinks to himself as he falls.
It would really help with a lot of this water spillage.
Right, I guess his name's Doug. I guess that's canon now.
Doug Slate.
I hate Slate. Reminds me of Jack Slate. He was an idiot.
Who's Jack Slate?
You know, from the Dead to Rights games.
I don't think I've played much of
those. It's a really dumb, white, Anglo-Saxon, tough guy name. That's Slate.
Well, that's why I think it juxtaposes funny with, like, the innocuousness of Doug.
Yeah, he's wearing, like, three bath mats that have been stitched together. But he's got a bath mat jumper on.
Mat then, really?
Now, I'm going to play just this intro bit that takes us through the character creation, and then I'm going to pass it to Gabriel for the first playthrough, because there's a tutorial at the start.
Have the controls changed at all?
Why do you always ask me questions you could find the answer to if you were just patient?
Well, because I want more time to think and prepare, because I don't like surprises. I don't want to get in and have, like, shield and hit, you know, just popped around.
No, it hasn't changed much.
Okay.
B is roll, hold down B.
Is jog.
And jumping is a little trickier. Oh, wait, did I...
I think if you just tap it again as you're running.
Hang about. I'm trying to... That's it. Yeah. You have to press in the left trigger to jump now.
Oh, okay.
Although you can change it to the classic thing, but I found that slightly less reliable in this game.
He doesn't jump as far, I've noticed.
Do you think?
Yeah. Oh, no, that was further. Must have been on a bit of a hill or something.
Yeah, probably. So here we are in Things Betwixt.
Oh, okay.
Which is the sort of intro land. That crazy whirlpool took us here for no reason. I'm not sure what that whole business was in aid
of. This is the universe bath mat that picks up the spills of souls.
I think we're just in like a ravine. Yeah. And there's like the sunlight spilling through from the top.
I don't think that's anything over
there. There's a way to go through somewhere. I'm trying to find a fellow with a big bum.
Yep.
Well, that's the obvious way to go.
Yeah.
What do we know about Dark Souls?
Explore.
Never take the obvious path.
Okay.
Yeah, the trigger and shoulder buttons are still...
We're on the trail of significant foot.
Mm-hmm. Be very, very quiet. Nope, I think we've found him.
Hmm. Hi, buddy. Are you a hitty friend or a talky friend?
Now, spoiler warning... I'm not going to attack that guy, because I'm not stupid.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend that.
But this is more sort of a thing you do in your new game pluses. Because those ogre guys are fucking brick shithouses.
Okay, so he is a hitty friend.
Yes, he's a very hitty friend.
Okay. Well, you can't judge on sight in Dark Souls, you know? Every now and then someone's like,
tell me about it.
Have a helmet.
I remember playing Bloodborne. I accidentally killed Patches the Spider before I knew he was a friendly NPC.
Yeah, I think
What do you want? He was a spider.
Yeah, and I shot a woman who was a wolf with an arrow from a distance, and then she chuckled at me and went
bath
away.
Bath mats for sale.
I see you're already wearing yours.
Yes, you're all wearing your bath mats. You are a good bath mat using household.
Oh my!
Your face is covered in bath mats.
Hello, I'm Doug Slate.
No, it's Slate. We're not Slate. We're gonna come up with something better than that.
Doug Slater.
No, that's a character from Saved by the Bell, isn't it?
It could be. Holy crap. Chicks.
Yeah.
You spoke to that kind old dear, didn't you?
I guess they're implying that we were tricked here or something. By the kind old dear.
Ah, the hag. The crone. More crones. I'm tired of dealing with crones.
This isn't exactly the encouraging conversation we need for our first day at work, madam.
Feast upon their soul.
What are you drinking? What industry do you have going here? Is that water? Do you make tea? What do you make tea out of?
What's the cup made of for a start?
Ogre tooth.
Looks like a bit of copper drain pipe.
I love that their table is just one enormous lump of possibly rock.
Or wood.
Yeah.
You'd think that would be an ask to get in here.
Petrified.
Right.
Doug Slate.
No, we're not called Doug Slate.
Yes, we are.
Our name is Douglas Upperty. This will be our name.
No.
No, it's good that you hate it. It means it can grow on you.
Douglas Upperty.
Yes, I'm very sure. Well, since I made that command decision, you can decide what Douglas Upperty looks like.
Oh, you're gonna regret that. You're gonna
within
miss,
reason.
You're gonna miss Doug Slate. Yeah. Doug Slate would have looked normal. Douglas Upperty looks like a fucking nitwit.
We're going to have to live with this character for the whole game, yeah. You understand?
Yeah, I'm coping with Douglas Upperty. I'm gonna cope with some Nigel Thornberry looking motherfucker.
So, features that have changed since Dark Souls that you won't be familiar with,
mm-hmm.
is that instead of expending humanity at bonfires to turn human, now you can just expend a human effigy wherever the hell you like to become human.
Okay, what's the pros and cons of turning human in this one?
Well,
are we on the internet? Because I don't want invasions.
Yep, we're online. But the thing with Dark Souls 2 is that you can get invaded while hollow.
That's not cool.
But it's a turnaround. You're less likely to be invaded when you're human.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
See, that's better.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Right, what class do you favor?
Okay, are they really very different from... Oh, Swordsman wasn't there always.
Not hugely. I don't like dual weapons, though, since I'm playing half of this.
Well, I don't either. I prefer a sword than a shield.
Yeah,
so.
Well, warrior and knight are the simple
high
class.
High strength and dexterity.
That the pussies use.
And knight'll be a lummox.
I'd probably
go warrior.
I played through the original version of the game, because this is Scholar of the First Sin that's changed things around. I've only played through this version once. I played through the previous version a few times. Played once as cleric. That was quite fun.
I've never used magic or anything like that. I'd say if we're going to be sharing it, I'd rather we go like warrior or something.
Naturally.
Because that's simple.
Big punt.
Yeah, well, it's hit and block.
Okay.
Or knight, but knight, I've found that like if you don't have a decent roll, later enemies will just fucking kill you.
I favor... Where are we? I'm just checking out the stats. I might want to, like, you know, veto our way to a couple of spells later on. So I might suggest knight for the higher...
Intelligence?
Slightly higher faith and stuff.
Faith. Alright, well, knight. Yeah, I'm fine. I don't care.
Wait, what's the... Hang on.
I don't know.
I don't remember what all these stats are. Okay, yeah, the head's intelligence.
Noggin!
I've only got 3 intelligence.
Hello!
That's shit for sorcerers. Okay, warrior's got higher intelligence, so I'm gonna say warrior. So there we can maybe have some sorceries later.
Okay, see, I haven't used any magic.
Why the fuck not, right?
Yeah.
Who's is there?
Hello!
The explorer gets pyromancy, I think.
I don't want to deal with, like, weird niche builds. That's...
Pyromancy's great, man. I think pretty much every character I've ever had has had some degree of pyromancy.
Huh.
Well, whatever. Warrior it is. And gift?
Well, I'm not sure what the gifts are like.
Okay.
Because last time there was the master key, and that was kind of useful.
Life ring's kind of shitty. Just a little bit of extra health.
And human it's effigy
kinda,
that...
Kind of not that great after you've leveled up a little bit.
Yeah.
Human effigies, just like starting
another
with
one,
twin humanities. A bunch of healing items. That's the other thing, is that the healing items have changed a fair bit.
Okay.
I'll explain in more detail once we get the Estus Flask, but basically the healing starts us off finding it easier to heal ourselves.
Might be a good idea.
Homeward Bone, Seed for Tree of Giants, I think...
Inedible.
I'm not sure what those do.
That's probably not much later.
Bonfire aesthetics that you throw into a bonfire to make surrounding enemies harder.
Don't want that.
I'm going to guess we don't want that.
Petrified something.
Same, you can't get black fire bombs. That's a
simple
gift
petrified
in this game.
Lump. It's a petrified something. It may be of use.
I think that's something you give to the equivalent of Snuggly the
Crow. I was gonna say, dead on, that was what I was thinking. There'll be some fucking bullshit you gotta give it to him. I don't know. I mean, if we're gonna. I'd go healing wares if that's sort of useful.
That's fair enough. That's a popular starting gift for the pussy newbies. Right.
All right, body. I get to change what he looks like.
How do you use it?
L or R? Wait, look down. The D-pad.
Okay, there we go. I guess we could be a Lady Douglas.
Dougina.
Or not. What sort of build should we have?
Fattest there is.
I had a feeling you'd say that.
There we go.
Fat bastard. Incredibly muscular and fat.
Well, we're going to be covered in armor, so it doesn't matter. So no, I don't need to see that kind of...
I mean, one could say the same for all these. aesthetic things. That
I get to do
gonna
this.
We're going to be covered in armor, like, instantly, so who the fuck cares?
I don't... What is this attached to? Homeland. Okay. Oh.
Yeah. Are you from Pastyland? Or one of the three varieties of Brown Town? Okay, the worst haircut possible, imaginable. Perhaps we should have gone for Dugina after all.
Yeah, you should have.
Well, those are some crazy brows.
There are some options. Oh, do I get no eyebrows? I'm starting to look like Yolande Visser. Alright, we'll go.
Starting to look like a social justice warrior. Naturally. You got the two extreme ends of the color you choose for your transparency when designing pixel sprites. And facial hair. So, I guess we're establishing in our backstory that Douglas identifies as something.
Oh, you'll never know. That's a constant.
I think he identifies as a transsexual Mario brother. Do you want a face tattoo?
Yes.
Just to round things out.
It's a me, Transio. Do I get to decide where it is?
I think if you go to the advanced settings, yes. You have to back out.
Okay. We'll deal with that later.
I want to kill some monsters sometime today, man.
Okay.
I go down to tattoo.
Kind of weird that they're in different places.
I'm guessing I know why Douglas Uppity was shunned by his homeland. Because he was embarrassing everyone. He looks like a bellend.
Okay, B cancels. That's good to know.
Well, that's Japanese games for you. Are you done? Are you dignified? Yes, alright. I think we're past the point where all detail is going to be lost the instant we start playing, because we're just going to be wearing a helmet and viewing ourselves from far away.
That's still pretty good to me.
Well, take your jollies where you can.
Well, that's what you get calling him, fucking Uppity. All right, so that's it. We're picked.
So,
is it, yes, you have no idea. Dark Souls 2. This is
actually
so my true self.
Well, yes, you're controller now, man. You're in charge.
Oh, so that was the intro.
Actually, my true self is a dragon called Mephistopheles.
Bumble Stiltskin.
But while I'm stuck in this terrible human form, I must tolerate this mortal build. Ooh, bit of a V-sync tear there.
Yeah. All right, look, old ladies, if I wanted to be laughed at, I could go talk to my parents.
Are you surprised that they're laughing at you?
Yes.
Look at yourself.
They're ugly.
Douglas Uppity.
Old and ugly.
You look like the Joker fell into the vat next door.
I'm the prankster.
You look like
Captain Harlequin.
You look like a fucking Rubik's Cube.
Probably shift around my face parts and come out with something normal looking.
So Grandma Jo here is
ooh, erotic.
Filling us in for what we can expect for the next 40 hours.
Game design that hates you.
By the way, we're recording this in 30 FPS because Australian internet being what it is, I don't want to have to spend the better part of an entire weekend uploading these sodding videos. So all you fucking Master Race assholes who are afraid of watching anything that's not absolutely perfect visually because you're afraid your eye sockets might turn into little toilets and your eyeballs into little poos inside the toilets.
That's fantastic. That's all I can see now is just toilet eyes with little poop pupils.
Then you can fucking live with it. And by the way, because you picked warrior, we start with a broken-ass sword. I hope you're pleased with yourself.
Oh, I'm sure we'll find another one soon.
You're going to you know, continue the game then.
Well, yeah, I'm having a fucking look around. I'm refamiliarizing myself with the general feel of the controls.
All right. I think there's a chest upstairs.
Well, there we fucking see. That's, you know.
Well, if you're going to look around, at least look upstairs.
Look, I'm in no fucking rush, all right? You can be the rush player.
Evidently.
Can I break
not.
Things? Yeah.
Naturally, man. You didn't hit it first. You haven't played Dark Souls enough.
No, I have, which is why I know that there's no way there's going to be a fucking mimic this early.
You never know.
Yeah, I do. That's why it wasn't a mimic.
Though Dark Souls 1 had... basically, the tutorial of Dark Souls 1 was, here's a fucking boss.
Yeah, but that wasn't hidden. Like
the way we came in, I think, dude.
Huh? Oh, yeah, isn't there another way out here?
Yes, and there's another door. That's the way you're supposed to go.
Alright, okay.
Yeah, so Dark Souls 1 just went, here's a big fat ass dropping on your head. Kill him. Now. And then you're ready. This game, on the other hand, actually just has a tutorial.
God damn it.
Just hit it with your stick.
Oh, I can. Oh, okay.
There, now you can have a thing.
Soul of a Lost Undead and something.
So Dark Souls 2 also has more of an emphasis on light. Because
it's actually dark.
You can light torches at fires. Of course, in the original release of Dark Souls 2, they fucked up. They fucked that up. They made it so you could see all the dark areas just by turning the brightness up. That's been fixed in this one.
Fiddlesticks.
Places are black as black. You got to have your fucking torch out for some places.
Hmm.
So when you see a flaming torch like that,
mm-hmm.
you can light a torch on it by walking up to it. And then you can light other torches from your lit torch. But your torch will only be lit for temporarily. So you've got one torch, so we've got 5 minutes of torch in it. And you can unequip it and save it just by pressing left on the D-pad.
Oh, so if I put it away, I come back with 4 minutes and 48 seconds. Yeah.
Have to light the torch again on something.
What happens if it burns down the full amount of time? Then I have to find another whole torch?
Yeah, but every torch you get just adds another 5 minutes to your maximum time. It's more like one torch that you keep refilling.
All right.
Yes, there's another fat boy.
I might light all the things along here. I don't think it's prudent to go into these yet.
There's something special that happens if you light all the torches. It's called bugger all.
Well, I just thought it might be, do they stay lit?
Yeah, the torches do.
Yeah, well, I think it might be prudent
fixed,
just to have...
The fixed torches do.
I know.
You do want to go into those fog doors, because that's where the tutorials are.
Oh, okay.
Start with the first one for the most basic lesson.
See, that's a little bit sneaky, because...
I figure this will just be a refresher for you.
Yeah, I think that's important, because, again, I haven't played... Beyond the little bit I was fiddling with the other day, I haven't really played Dark Souls in about a year, which I think is long enough to lose some fucking important bits of...
Yeah, well, ooh. Roll and block, and
Good lock-on, still the same.
Bait them into attacking, and then hit them. That's about the size of it. Okay. Well, that's the first of many.
Oh, I can change target now. That's cool. Let's see what my block's like. Yeah.
Okay, the forfeit, when you die... and pass the controller over, is that you then have to tell us about an event from Douglas Upperty's previous life that have shaped the man he is today. All right?
Okay. All right.
Well, you need to find a torch to light your torch on if you want to light that torch.
So it doesn't come out unless... It
doesn't come out unless... Oh,
I see. It's its own little category. There we are, yeah. All right.
Yes. So, if you want to light that torch, you're going to have to go back to one of those lit torches.
Mm.
If we had a flame butterfly, you can use that to light your torch from wherever. But those are dispensable.
No, you don't, dickhole. Oh, I don't get that.
Want to try go for the backstab?
Okay, is it still light attack from behind?
Yep.
Alright, come on.
When you're ready. Oh, there you go.
Oh, that was it, okay.
Got your backstab down.
Yeah, that's important.
Yeah, that's very fucking important. How are you on parrying? I wouldn't go near that fella.
Never that good, to be honest. Well, I mean, it's there, it's just...
This is where you're supposed to learn backstabbing. I think it was made a bit easier in Dark Souls 2. Dark Souls 1, you had to be right behind them.
Yeah,
Yeah. I think it's a little bit more generous with the maximum space you can move around.
Ooh, a treat.
A dagger. Is that an improvement on our broken sword, I wonder?
Hmm.
Not really.
No.
Because the other thing you have to remember is that weapon degradation is a much more serious thing in Dark Souls 2. Because weapons are all healed back up at bonfires. So that does, and but the trade-off for that is they degrade much faster.
Alright, so the timing's a bit different. Yeah. There we go.
Yeah, I never really mastered parrying in any Dark Souls game. Which really left me unprepared for Bloodborne.
Yeah.
That's a parry up the ass game.
Yeah, because I was thinking, like, I'm a, you know, a tank, so I was like, block, stab.
But I think you can block in Bloodborne.
No, you can't. There's no shields. Yeah, that fucked me up.
Yeah, because you only play like the tank, which is the easiest kind of character to play in Dark Souls. Hide behind your big 100% shield. Never have to worry about anything. Except magic.
Sensible.
Except magic and fire attacks, of course.
Okay, so the dagger gets through some of that shit. Alright. You wanna go? Huh? Yeah, I got your fucking shit right here, you.
Douglas Uppity has some issues.
Yeah, man. Well, look at that hair.
Where did he learn all these warrior skills as a bath mat salesman?
On Twitter. Douglas Uppity was a committed Twitter space activist. That's where he learned all these practical real-world skills.
Maybe he just learned it all from YouTube tutorials.
Oh, yeah, totally. Oh, okay.
Yeah. I would hope we'd establish that.
Yeah, like...
By this point.
Oh, hey!
Hey, it's the crows! I think there's two of them in this game.
Give us smooth.
Oh. Yeah. That's the hint, that the item they most want is smooth and silky stones.
Okay.
If you find any of those. But you can also stick petrified somethings in there. There to get something.
Ooh.
But you can pretty much stick anything in, like, the crow's nest and get something.
Aww.
Well, we can't, because we haven't got a lit torch.
What happens if I light, if I get that torch?
Nothing.
Oh, okay.
You just have a lit torch.
Oh, wait, that's my one back here.
Right, what haven't we learned yet?
I suppose a lot of defense and evasion wasn't really in there.
I guess rolling and drop attacks and stuff. Oh, yes, and two-handed. Yeah, two-handed shield, probably not going to be much use, if I'm honest. Well, that's hardly better than one-handed.
Oh, okay, that was...
You took
long
that
wind
in.
Up on that.
You took that on the stash.
Got you, motherfucker! Shitlord. Surrounded by shitlords.
Yeah, it's Shitlord City. Okay, this is a popular place to experience one's first death in Dark Souls 2.
Okay.
Trying to jump that gap.
Okie dokie.
To get the thing at the far side, which probably isn't worth it, thinking about it. Hey, look at you. Of course, getting back's where it gets complicated.
Amber Herb.
If memory serves, that restores a couple of uses.
Hello.
Yes, we've established how
awful.
We've established how awful your face is. Oh, look Douglas Uppity. Well, hush my mouth. That's where That's where I got the Welcome to Dark Souls achievement. Which you get for your first death. Right, I think this is the time to learn about drop attacks.
Left button, right button, out left button.
Yeah, that's like the kick and the jump attack from Dark Souls 1.
Oh, okay.
You're familiar with that?
Okay, yeah, that's the guard break.
That's the guard break, which was the kick in Dark Souls 1. Thank you, demonstrating hologram things.
Thanks, other guy. What the fuck?
You fucked up. You continue to fuck up.
Fuck this shit.
It's fucking up central. Oh, got a whole 570 souls already. Thought we'd only kill like 5 dudes. They have a lot of souls, those guys.
They are soulful.
It's like cats, how they got 9 lives.
And
that guy had like about 30 of them, it seems. That is the item.
So what's the life gem do?
That just restores life.
Oh, okay. So that's the little healing doodad that I got.
Yes.
That's the gift.
You do get an Estus flask, but it starts off with only 1 use. You have to upgrade its number of uses by finding items in the world.
Okay.
By finding Estus flask shards. But yeah, so bonfire kindling isn't a thing anymore.
Okay.
Most of the time in the early game, you'll be getting your health back with life gems.
Can I pick up more of them? Can I restore them?
You pick them up everywhere, man. They're a very common drop. And you can buy a lot of them from places.
Okay, so that's a slow rebuild.
Yeah, but it's a lot faster to use than Estus because you can still move while using it.
Is that just
you ain't getting over there.
I thought I could maybe do a
sprinty
jump.
If you drop down, if you drop Dune, you'll notice a fella standing in the way of that cave.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to look at him.
And he's a statue.
Oh, okay.
And there's a couple of places in this game blocked off by statues. You can only get rid of statues with a special item whose name I forget for the moment.
Chip.
And you just find them at like plot moments and...
Okay, so that's...
You find them in like chests as like one-time items and you use them to open up new areas.
Statue be gone. Notes.
Yay, this is where it starts.
Do it!
Hurrah for message, by the way, praise the sun. Well, can do. Tough enemy ahead, meaning the whole game.
Yeah. Run forward with my shield out, just to guard against any surprise bullshit.
You'll be safe for a while.
I don't trust you.
This is like the hub of the whole game, Majula. Oh, okay. This is where you come back to level up and upgrade your equipment.
This is such a pleasant area as opposed to...
Well, yes, it is nice. Don't go that way.
Why?
Because there's nothing there. We want to get started on the actual game, don't we?
Okay. Well, I'm poking around. What do you got? Oh, that sounds
Divine
nice.
Divine Blessing.
What does that do?
Just restores.
Look at it.
Restores health.
Okay.
I think. So there's.
What a lovely day at the beach.
So the bonfire's over there.
The sun oppresses my fail skin.
In that ring of stones.
I run because I want to.
And we want to find the Emerald Herald.
So I can quick travel, like, is that what travel is?
Yes, you can. In this game you can, don't get that way either, you can instantly quick travel between any bonfire.
Huh. What the hell?
That way...
That was cosmic.
That way will lead to the first area. We want to talk to a lady on the cliff behind us.
What, like up there?
No. Go back to the bonfire. And see that dead tree...
Yep.
Or the one on the right.
Yeah.
Go over to there.
Yeah, there she is.
Yes. This character is basically our mum. Yes, very mature. I've never heard that one before.
Are you the next monarch?
She is the person who levels us up. And she'll be here basically for the whole game, saying mysterious things. Basically, she's
clearly the herald of fate. Look at me.
She's that weird patchy face lady from Demon Souls. Or the doll from Bloodborne. Who was it in Dark Souls?
I think there really wasn't. There were just a few people.
Well, there were a few guys who used to hang around the...
Nope.
What's it called? Something Shrine.
I don't remember.
What was that place called that you went to all the time in Dark Souls?
Firelink.
Firelink Shrine. Thank you. Yeah. So, here's the story so far. We have to find the souls of four powerful beings, meaning boss monsters. That's all we got, frankly.
Yep. It's all you ever really
Venture
need.
Venture out into the land, find some shit. Murder things.
Obviously, can't you tell by my mustache?
This man is smelling us. Thank you, strange man. We very much enjoy being smelled.
You smell of the undead.
Yeah, yeah, shut up.
Yes, yes. Bizarre, strange. Right. Bizarre, strange, strange. Okie dokie.
Talk to that fella sitting by that house.
This guy?
Yeah. He's the smith, and he will upgrade our weapons once we've got titanite. Once we've unlocked the door of his house. But we won't be getting that till we find the first merchant. So,
how are you dying around here?
There's an item there. Just behind the house there, on the edge of the cliff.
Huh.
Careful.
A little less visible in the sunlight.
More life gems. 3 to be precise.
Sweet. So is this a little bit like Bloodborne, where life gems are a fairly common enemy drop while located?
Yes.
Right. Right. Well, that's good to know.
You'll get a fuckload of life gems.
Oh, that's good. I like life gems.
Did Holdy Lady give you your Estus flask?
Yeah.
Well, make sure you put it in your quick items.
Should I? Really? So should I? Actually, if it's got one, I thought I was saving it for a bit.
Just equip. Just put it in the item next to your life gem. And then you can just quickly switch to it by pressing down on the D-pad. I'd also recommend putting the Cure Poison on there as well, because you never know, and you're always going to need Cure Poison fast.
Oh, okay, so what have I got here?
That's the green mossy lump just under the Estus flask.
Oh, that's right, so I've got a lot of them.
Those are the more powerful life gems.
Spell uses.
And we've got good old-fashioned souls of soldiers and shit. And the dark sign. And the multiplayer stuff.
Multiplayer in this is strange. There's no, there's chairs everywhere. There are chairs fucking everywhere.
Still in the menu. There you go. Well, yes. You gotta have something to take out your frustrations on. See, if this were Castlevania Dawn of Sorrow, we could acquire a soul that allowed us to heal up by sitting in chairs.
Hmm.
No such luck, I'm afraid. Now, whenever I play Warrior, I always end up using a Great Shield. Put it all in strength and get that fucking tower Great Shield. That shit's the bomb.
Yep. Mustache.
Yes, we're all enjoying the mustache.
Oh. Gonna go through your stuff, buddy. Hope you don't mind.
Of course he doesn't. I mean, we're his only customer. He should be kissing our feet the instant we walk in the door.
Yeah, even though I'm stealing his shit. Okay, how are people dying? This must be like PvP or something, right?
I guess
this doesn't seem like an area with hostiles.
Well, I think a lot of these NPCs turn hostile if you start smacking them about.
I'm not gonna do that.
But I wouldn't.
No, I don't want
to. Well, there are hostiles.
Is he talking about souls? Like, is that how much the shit costs is in souls?
Yeah.
Okay.
But there are...
Should I buy anything at this point? Like, it feels like a little early.
No.
Like, I always feel like buying stuff at the first guy you find is usually a little bit of a mistake.
You want to get your teeth into some combat first. Try to figure out what you need and what you don't need.
Excuse me!
Talk to the cat.
Oh. Well, hello, fellow.
Yeah, it's a talky cat.
Okay.
And I think it's a lady cat. One without much time remaining.
Just about ready to fall apart, I'd say. Yep, this universe is bordering on collapse.
Lady cat sells a couple of really useful things. Actually, sells a ring that reduces fall damage, which is very, very handy for certain very specific parts of the game.
Oh, yes.
And that's Shalqua.
Enchanté.
Enchanté. Meow.
Who wants a chin tickle? Who wants a chin tickle?
She's not that brazen. She feels she has to seduce us into a chin tickle. She's no slut. Yeah, you can also abandon covenants with her, because she's such a slut, as we've established.
Whore.
And she encourages sluttiness in all others. Did you ever use alluring skulls in Dark Souls?
Nope.
Even in the bit where you're supposed to learn about them, where you're supposed to throw one in a fire to kill the armored piggy at the undead burg.
Oh, is that what you're supposed to do?
Yes! That's the first time you get them.
Oh, I just jumped down and hit the thing until it died.
Yeah, and it was a bit of an arse, wasn't it?
I don't know. Apparently I got real lucky killing it the first time, because it got stuck in the fire.
Yeah.
Just automatically.
That is pretty lucky.
I would like a better sword.
Well, best thing to do is go out into the world and start killing shit.
Alright, so it's go fighty time now, is it?
Yeah, might as well.
So, rock and roll!
Let's go down that path I discouraged you from earlier.
Now we're going for a trip down Discouragement Lane.
Yes, indeed.
Alright.
And Discouragement Lane is best known for its pools of blood. That's why they call it Discouragement Lane.
Why are you people dying around here?
Oh, hey, I think there's something you can do in Majula I forgot about. Okay. Pass the controller a sec. Because I don't want to have to describe the whole action to you.
Why? This is part of the game.
Okay.
That's how it works.
Well, go back to the area around that big pit.
Alright.
And...
I'll take a running jump off of this.
No. If you go over to that well on the right. Do you see that well?
Yes.
Well, go up to it. You'll see a rock on the side of the well.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to smack that rock. And jump back. There it is. Now go take that to Hoodie Lady.
Hoodie.
Because that is the first Estus Flask shard. Now we have two Estus Flasks, not just one.
And the Estus work like normal.
Yeah,
where...
the Estus is as before. They restore at bonfires.
Right.
Life gems do not. Estus does.
Okay.
That's the trade-off. There's more life gems, but they are...
I didn't want to re-destroy Butthole again.
They are depletable.
Yeah, I will. Just let me...
Get used to those four lines of dialogue. Bearer, seek, till.
Yeah.
You got two of them, motherfuckers. How much do we need to level up? 300 more.
Shouldn't be too hard.
Let's go kill something! Woo!
Actual social justice warrior.
If you'd gone down the alleyway behind that big mansion where the well was, you'd have found some little piggy monsters. But they're surprisingly hard to kill for this early in the game. So I wouldn't bother if I were you.
Oh. Halberd. Good to see those make a comeback. I like the halberds.
Those are handy for your strength builds. Or are they more dexterous? I can never remember. Halberds are good for high damage, yes. But after playing Bloodborne a bit, sometimes it's better to lean towards fast attack than high damage. But you never used magic much.
No.
You gotta have some kind of ranged attack, I find. Okay, that's your argument.
Rain and hit things, yeah.
That's your argument, is it?
Well, yeah, I never really use range. There was one thing I used range on, which was the giant fuck-off bow against the red drake on the thing.
Cause right, right.
Fighting him the traditional way is fucking bullshit.
I think you can even get him down until you hit him with an arrow or something.
No, he'll land, but he'll just do these huge fucking fire... attacks, and even with all the like super, there's a blood stain here, and that makes me paranoid.
Well, yes. Nope. If you fall in that water, you die. That's why there's a blood stain there. But if you can jump over to that shallower bit of water, we can see there's another item to get, which is a Omwood bone.
Boner. Okay. Don't know about that.
Oh.
Am I allowed to walk through this?
Yeah.
Fatty ahead.
Yes. Okay, gloves are off now.
Okay,
this
so
this fatty was not there before Scholar of the First Sin. This was one of the many changes as far as the first... I wouldn't attack him. I'd just try to scoot around him if I were you.
Yeah, he seems to leave me be.
Yeah. Okay, well, those guys tend to be placid until you get close. But they've pranked me before. They've right. snuck up on me when I thought they were minding their own business elsewhere.
Yeah, you got a two hit, huh?
Yeah, and a big axe. So watch it.
Fuck you, Homeslice. I got my shitty broken sword. Staying with a broken sword for so long makes me incredibly uncomfortable.
Well, you're bound to pick something up off one of these guys sooner or later.
Now, can I sneak up on him and get a backslash?
No. The answer to that is no.
Missed me.
Now you got to piss at me.
Huh, alright. That guy was going fucking apeshit on nothing.
Well, that's Hollows for you. Is that a sword? No, it's a helmet.
I wonder if that's any better.
Probably not, considering you're a warrior. Yeah. Warrior starts with decent shit.
Nope.
Well, nope. It's better against one thing.
I kind of want to.
Don't. Well, if you want me to suddenly be the one playing, then be my guest.
Well, I mean, it feels like I've been playing for a while, and I think, you know, fortune can sometimes favor the bold.
Well, okay. Welcome to Dark Souls.
Yeah, I mean, I have to die at some point. I haven't fallen in any of the stupid pits
you might,
that killed
you. Well, you might not die. Let's see how you do against Mr. Ogre Pants. This is the point where all the viewers who've played this game start sniggering.
Whoop. Whoop. Oh, dear.
Who wants to have a little, he's saying.
All right.
Well, he lost some health. Wow.
I am not fucking hurting him at all. Oh, shit.
Oh, well, I'm afraid you've decided things for yourself now, because he's going to come and finish the conversation.
Uh-oh.
And he's got and he's got pals. You just don't really want to know what's going on behind you at this point, do you? You're getting hollowed, son. Bit of a lag spike there. Yep, I saw that coming.
If it wasn't for the lag, I'd have rolled. Right. There you go.
Now tell me a little bit about Douglas Appleby.
His favorite bath mat was actually not the one that he was instructed to sell most of. And
I see. He was conflicted.
Constantly torn between his respect for his craft and the people who actually put a lot of effort into constructing fine bath mats, and the commercial realities of having to support a family on a bath mat salesman wage.
Did you reverse up-downy camera controls?
Of course I did.
Are you mad? Who the hell does that?
Only the truly sane. Let's change it back.
I'm gonna change it back. I will.
D-pad home slice.
You mad person. That's Godzone controls.
Actually, now that I come to think of it, attacking him when I had still the broken sword, I should have waited till I had a full sword. I just wanted to take him on.
That would have helped.
Well, I need a basis. You know, I need a fucking... Now I have an idea.
Those ogres do not give a shit.
Oh, we're hollow. And we still have the radiant colored hair and mustache. That's fantastic. Oh, God, it's every third girl on Tinder.
If you say so. Bad complexions.
Do we keep all... It's like the last time we keep all the stuff we found, right?
Yes.
All right, cool.
So, yes, we were really conflicted about selling the bath mat we didn't think was superior.
Had to, though.
We'd had a lot of arguments with our superiors. And a couple of times, the people we were selling them to said things like, "Are you sure this is the best bath mat? I've heard there might be better ones." And our hearts would weep.
That's so much.
Now, I tend to be a defensive player. When you're ready.
Yeah, you see, like, you just... Ah, fucking goddamn the ground.
I think my target is trying to trick me there.
I'd love it if he reacted to sort of target focus, like...
There's the bonfire you didn't notice. Yeah,
well, no, I didn't notice it because I was being attacked by an ogre for some reason.
Well, no. I can never remember if you have to rest at it before it counts. Oh, a whole bunch
Travel?
Of messages just appeared.
Hurrah for recklessness. Indeed.
Yeah, I think you and that guy are on the same page.
Yep, all the guys come back.
Natch.
Hey, shouldn't my pile of souls be around somewhere? Because we could be getting close to a level up soon.
Yeah, I think we'd pretty much be at it.
Get behind.
He foiled me.
He was going apeshit on the ground for so long.
Yes, there's our blood stain.
Alright, careful, there's a lot of guys around here.
Yeah.
Fuck your feet!
It's the arrow guy you gotta watch out for, yeah?
Range jerks.
Yeah, use that bow. That's working out for you. You twat. There's a
Hey, you hot bucket of dick buggery. Yeah, that guy's going for the slow axe. Hey, you got a better sword than me. Fuck you. I want your sword. Oh.
Well, there's three of them now. Like, they were camouflaged for a bit there. Okay, I'm just gonna get that guy out of the way.
Yeah, got him.
Oops. Welcome to Dark Souls.
Hell yeah. This is what makes it fun.
Hey, these guys are wearing Bath Matzer's jumpers.
That's a fucking crime. You're not allowed to do that.
This must mean our arch rival, Stephen Confident, has been through here already. We could have sold these guys bath mats. Stephen, you've gotten that bonus for the last time.
Damn, Stephen, and he's constantly getting the bath matty awards.
Yeah, I bet Stephen wrote that. He thinks he's so great, can tell everyone else how to do it.
All right.
I'm going to drink some ecstasy, you, Stephen Confident. This is good. We're building quite a backstory.
Should we go back and level now, or...?
Actually, well, everything's going to come back, isn't it? You know what? I know this game pretty well. I'm going to hold out for the next bonfire.
Okay. I think... Also, you can level at bonfires now.
Oh, no. But bonfires teleport.
Oh, yeah.
So you can teleport back to Majula and level up at the Emerald Herald.
Manjula. Whoop.
Emerald Herald? That almost rhymes. I was confident my second slash would recoil that guy. There was method to my madness.
No, that's the great thing about the the fight mechanics in this game. Your attack is an active hurtbox for a full solid swing.
Now an original.
Okay, now how many of these dickbags gonna? Huh? I'm
sure there's one up top who's gonna make his presence felt. Yes, there he is.
Banzai! Just comes crashing. Isn't the soul over there or something?
I think he's a ranged guy anyway. So I'm gonna take him out before I do anything else.
Oh, okay.
That's and here's another thing strategy. For Dark Souls 2, speed ladders. Oh, and this asshole. Yeah, come on then. You did not think your cunning plan through.
Should have stayed on the ladder and, forced me to fight you there.
Dig those ragdolls.
I love ragdoll effects. It's one of my favorite things in the world.
Tragically, you can't kick them around as much as you could in Dark Souls 1.
It's probably for the best. I mean, the way they hung on to you was a little bit silly.
Because in Dark Souls 2, they just sort of kill the physics as soon as it's at rest. Which is disappointing. Hello, you.
You're a bit odd.
Yeah. I'm getting bad luck with these backstabs.
It's light slash, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I was doing.
Oh! Ooh, cheeky fucking bugger.
I was about to say that very thing. Yes, that's what he would have done to us.
Cheeks.
If we'd stayed down there.
Oh, so we'd have been lobbing firebombs at us.
Yeah.
I hate
asshole.
Those. Yeah, short sword.
That's what we want.
Actual cutting implement.
Let's see how that serves.
Oh, we got another thing as well.
Oh, yeah.
That's up to 100. Fuck yeah.
That's the dagger we got earlier. Now, if memory serves, we do have to watch out for the degradation on this weapon. So keep an eye on the little red bar under the weapon icon in the lower left. That will show how much it is degraded.
Okay.
You don't want to be caught with a weapon that's just about to break.
I can imagine.
Quite something ahead.
Delicious.
A soul of a nameless soldier. You disappoint me. Message. That was not quite something.
I think with all the souls and stuff, we can probably level up pretty... Isn't there stuff down near the base of the tree still?
Yes.
Yeah. There's a good sense of height and space in these games. I always enjoyed that.
How does one get up there? Get that item there.
Stop swinging the gizmo about.
Well, not by falling down there, I think.
No. Maybe come at it from another angle.
I don't trust Fall stuff.
It's Dark Souls, so you're right.
Oh, wait, we can probably... I guess we can jump from here? Let's see what this
pool
of blood
did. Yeah, give
it
the old college try. All right. Okay, so he fucked up the jump.
Yeah,
that
guy fucked it up.
Yeah, we won't. We're champions.
Let me just clear up this area, though.
Yep. Oh, actual damage. Actual damage. Oh, get a dog up here.
Well, we're still having to three-shot these guys.
Still. Better than, like...
Oh, and we got a thrust. I love thrusts.
Mmm.
Thrust is way better than a swing for narrow passageways.
Yeah.
Thrust your ass.
Stab. We got a block button.
Yeah, yeah. More life gems. One life gem.
Hmm.
Another broken straight
sword.
Why
would I want a broken one? I don't know.
Well, we only started with a broken straight sword because we were the warrior. Maybe if we wanted to make a collection, that's where we'd get it.
Can we, like, is there a... Do we have to wait till, like, a Framp shows up before we can sell this crap, or does it just... Merchant it pretty well early.
There is a guy you can sell things to, but he's much harder to find than Framp.
Oh, fig piggles.
What is it with you and figs?
Should we be human just on account of the possibility of invasion? Because I've done very little PvP at all in any of the Souls games.
I don't think I've ever been invaded in this area. I know there's some areas that are very invasion heavy.
Probably like, yeah, there'll be PvP
Another
areas.
Another one. Bloody hell.
We don't need that many. I don't know. So there's probably someone out there dual wielding two broken swords. Fuck yeah, about time. I got my dual wield.
Always makes you think of those bloody adventure games.
Which one?
George Stolbout, madam. The broken sword.
Oh, yeah. There's like five of those now.
Yeah, there's a new one coming out soon.
Oh, really? I've got them. I'm gonna play through them eventually. Oh, yeah!
I didn't call that a backstab.
That's, yeah. It's a back fury.
I don't know what the hell that was. Hollow infantry boots. Well, obviously they're hollow.
There's nobody in them anymore.
That was quite witty.
Therefore, praise the sun. Good job, champ.
Why do all these messages have like 96 upvotes? I've never gotten that many.
Because you don't put down like dumb fuck memes. That's why you don't get any upvotes.
I put down witty things.
Did I say witty things or dumb fuck memes?
Hey, double strong attack takes them out and straight away.
Fucking rad. All right. Yeah, you got them in a doorway. You want to penetrate them now. Fantastic.
Yeah, that was a double penetration.
Oh, yeah! DP. Was that guy guarding anything?
Let's try for a DVDA before this day is out.
I don't think that's possible we can manage.
What
There's
the hell were you attacking me with? Was it nothing?
His fist.
I think it was nothing, yeah. Yes.
Just shoving his hand at you in an aggressive fashion.
Found some crossbow bolts.
Hooray!
I do maintain we need a ranged attack of some kind.
If this one's suitably different to,
Stab. Stab.
Dead. Fuck yeah, real sword.
Stab. 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 You'll note our weapon strength is down to about 2/3, though.
Did they used to degrade this fast in the old...
No. Well, because the degradation was permanent in Dark Souls 1, you had to repair them at blacksmiths. But in this game, the degradation resets at bonfires.
Okay.
As I said earlier, but you never listen.
Oh, I'm just going thinking about other things. Oh, yeah, you cheeky bugger.
Yeah, see, here I'm in a bind, because there's this guy, but I'm directly underneath a guy who throws firebombs.
We'll just sprint up, take out the archer.
Okay, let's do that. Yeah, good plan, Gabe.
I said sprint up, not waddle up.
I am going to life gem this because I'm a bit.
Oh, there's another archer shooting at you.
Yeah.
Roll into the wall, adventure.
That's right. This was new for Scholar of the First Sin. Bollocks.
I want to let some of that. Let some of that endurance.
P. Yes. D. P. I'm making a habit of that. We say DP because our lost love was Doreen Prendergast.
She was a real beaut.
She was really into the DP. That's why we broke up.
Like a pair of Chinese finger traps.
I was like, why do you always insist on having a large black man when we make love? Just on hand.
Just on hand, just around.
Yeah, there's all sorts...
Club-a-lang.
All sorts of fun to do down that way. But first...
Isn't there a shiny thing to steal left? That's great. Fucking Dark Souls.
I fell for it. Fair one. Well, anyway. Bonfire time. They're much less spaced out than they were in... Oh, almost forgot.
Hello, I am a market.
See this pile of shit on the floor? It's a merchant. Most importantly, this merchant sells the key to that blacksmith's shop. The thieving bitch.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna get a couple of firebombs, because they're always handy to have.
That all looks like junk.
That axe is pretty good for like early game equipment.
Fists.
My name is Fist, or we get dragged.
I'm gonna talk
something,
to this.
Something when giants cross the sea.
Yeah. I'm gonna talk to this lady a whole bunch, and then if we deplete all her conversation, then later she'll show up at Majula, so we don't have to come all the way out here to buy things from her.
So we harangued an old lady until she moved.
Basically. And harangued her into coming to live with us.
Away!
She's like the old lady from Deadpool.
Oh, okay. Ow.
Are we boring you, Emerald Herald? do you think you could spare some time in your busy schedule to level us up?
Fucking hell! Should we give the blacksmith his key and see if we can... Or is leveling up? Like, what's better? Are we upgrading? Oh, Jesus.
That was quite a car crash of a sentence you just made.
Well, I mean, what are we upgrading? What's the best to upgrade first? Native stats or weapons?
Well, we've only got one Titanite shard at this point.
Alright, maybe we should, just upgrade ourselves.
Okay, when he says
first.
Come back later, what he means is sit at the bonfire.
With this fellow.
Stand up again, and then go over to him.
Oh, look at that, he's teleported. The magic of bonfires.
So I don't know if we want to start upgrading weapons yet, because I find you want to make sure you got a good base weapon first.
Yeah, well, I would have presumed that a shitty little poker isn't that fucking fantastic.
Let's see what he's got. Falchion, rapier. I said rapier. Maces.
Is there much variation in...
I think the Falchion's a curved... Yeah, the Falchion's a curved sword. Those are pretty good.
Well, yeah, that's the thing, like... Because there wasn't a huge amount of variation in what enemies were vulnerable to what types of weapon in the last one.
Well,
I'm curious if that's been sort of expanded upon in this. Like, I don't want to get, like, oh, that looks like a good weapon, and then have every fucking dick be resistant to, the fucking hammer.
Well, I think there's something for everyone in this game, in terms of weapon damage. The Falchion scales well as well. It's got a B on dexterity.
B.
You understand how that works, I'm sure. Rapier scales a bit better, being a D. I think we'll stick with the short sword for now.
I think just level.
I'm just gonna... Yeah, fuck you, Lenigrast.
Waste my time, fucking goddamn dick.
Let me just see what...
I got lots of broken swords.
Just trying to see what it scales with. That's right, it's on this screen. So we've got C&C on strength and dexterity, so it's a bit of an all-rounder.
So, the C&C on dexterity means as we upgrade strength and dexterity, we get a moderate, sort of an average upgrade of the damage value.
Yeah, I thought you were a Dark Souls player, man.
Oh yeah, I'm sort of...
Yeah, if we... That means
we maybe
get...
haven't played it, because a lot of the Dark Souls, this is not a very...
Yeah, it means the damage will scale moderately as we increase our strength and dexterity for that weapon. It's like that earlier weapon had a B on it. A B for dexterity, so that meant that the damage would scale a bit faster as we leveled up that weapon.
Whereas we leveled up our dexterity.
If we had higher dexterity. So, now we have to decide where to put our very first upgrade stat.
Level, yeah.
So... We can only get the 1 point. So there's health, endurance, both important, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Vitality increases equipment load. It's not grouped with endurance anymore.
Oh, that is dickish.
Achievement is for spells. Strength, dexterity, obviously. Adaptability, which is a little bit more useful than...
That would be like the resistance from the last one.
Yeah, but it's way more useful than resistance was in Dark Souls. I basically never leveled up resistance.
No, neither did I.
This is a bit better for like improving your like native defenses. And I think you drink Estus faster once you're with your...
That's
if you raise your
interesting
adaptability. And intelligence and faith for spells. So, I'm thinking either we sink into one of the two majors or strength and dex at this point. What do you think? Well, we're pretty high for strength already.
Yeah, I think maybe...
But do we want to emphasize strength or like go for an all-rounder sort of like build? I think it depends on what sort of weapons we like.
Well, I think given that there's two of us playing, perhaps an all-rounder. That, and I think a good strength dex mix is... That's fairly durable. Like, you can get through a game with that.
Okay, so let's put dex up, and then we got our options open, depending on what weapons we find.
Yeah.
Whether we want to go for a more dexy or a more strengthy weapon.
I think that gives us a good spread.
Alright.
Whom!
We're playing. We're playing Dark Souls.
Whee!
Back to the Forest of Fallen Giants.
That's something I'm going to have to keep in mind, that I can teleport around and level up and stuff like that.
Yeah. I'm sure you'll get used to it. Right. Let's get our explore on.
Yeah. Let's wander and wonder.
What did we say our rival's name was?
Stephen Confident.
That's the one. See if Stephen Confident has plied his wicked trade around here.
Filthy Stephen.
That door
is
locked.
Should we be human if that is... Are there other benefits to humanity? Like,
well, besides the damage increase and the ability to summon a friendly support character.
I've never
summoned
friends either. So, go back down the stairs a little
bit. I summon all the time.
Really?
Huh. I summon NPCs a lot.
I just...
In this game, there's a couple of boss fights I don't think I've ever beaten.
Rotate the
without,
camera a bit.
Without...
There's something on top of the tree branch.
Oh, yes. There, yeah. Yes, I'm
curious as to how...
I think we have to get through that door before we can get out of there.
Oh, okay. Well...
Because we need to drop through a hole.
Ah.
See, in this game...
not on the cards right now. Hey, what's that hole to the right? Is that a hole?
Yeah. That leads down to the next place we need to go. Before we go there, let's explore around...
Yeah, let's have a poke about.
This causeway sort of thing.
This safe area.
Ugh.
Fucking excellent!
I don't know what you're laughing
so
about.
So fucking good. I love Dark Souls moments. And that was a Dark Souls moment.
It sure was. Keep forgetting about that guy next to the door.
What's over there? Ah! Stab!
Time for a little sippy.
The game that hates you. Boop. There's guys. Blech. There's lots of guys. Don't fall off the edge.
Again, I was confident my slash would repel him.
Stab!
Yes, just a single P, but sometimes that's all you need.
Mm. One good lunge. Okie dokie.
What was that name I said? Doris Prendergast?
I think so.
Yes, our lost love.
Yeah.
Who was into the DP.
Ta-da! Hey, now we can be human again.
Why do we always have to go in the bum hole, Doris? Are you saying something about our relationship?
I want front! Touch your front butt. It's probably going to be someone. Interesting technique.
That was an acrobatic stab. DP, DP, again.
The collapsing lunge. What are the foot soldier swords like?
Well, let's find out.
Let's take a peek. Shitty.
I heard footsteps.
There's a bunch of stuff going on down there, but...
Yeah, it's those guys.
Yeah, it appears to be.
Well, they're not alerted.
No, you appear to be relatively...
Resume checking stuff.
Right.
Foot soldier sword. It's a bit better on the damage front. A bit worse everywhere else.
I think at this point maybe just a bit more damage is what we need.
Scaling's shitty as well.
Well, yeah, but I don't think we're in a position to be worrying about that at the moment. You know, we're still, we're level like 2.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'll put it in the offhand slot so we can try it out on the fly.
There we go. That's using the noodle.
Right, let's see what we have here. Whoa. Over to you, Gabe! Right,
this fucking cord?
Douglas met Doris Prendergast in a food court. When he had just emerged from the nearby JB Hi-Fi after they'd refused to give him a refund for an item he had bought in good faith. And they said they couldn't take it back because he'd obviously used it improperly.
Oh, shit.
Doris was sympathetic to his woes. She, having herself recently bought a slightly dodgy DVD player in a car boot sale. I think he's back there. Was then they discovered a shared love for car boot sales, which would lead to their early courtship and a brief dalliance in the antiquing trade. These memories flash through his mind as he picks through his old worn swords, looking for something good to use. How they would laugh as he would pretend to fence with his old antique swords.
That's interesting. If you're running against a wall, it cuts off the jump. Yeah, you come get me, champ.
Maybe go and get our bloodstain back.
Alright, you got a little more range than I thought.
He was getting his combo on.
He was throwing a tantrum. I don't think we can get back up, though. That's a problem.
Yeah, there's a way up.
Is there?
Well, if you see that hole in the wall in the distance, that leads into the tunnel we were in earlier that led to that.
Oh, okay.
The top of that causeway area. And we found some dirty secondhand gloves to consider for our antiques business. And they're shite, because a warrior starts with decent kit.
I suppose all this will be for the naked guy, right?
Yeah. The deprived. Which
sounds
like the name of a monster from The Consuming Shadow. Possibly. Whee!
Fucking gotcha!
That's when you turn the Dark Souls moment onto a Dark Souls moment. Getting your leap attack on.
Does the job.
Is that still the Hollowfoot Soldier sword you're using?
I think so, yeah.
Seems to be more of a slashy weapon.
Okay, I don't think we can get... You know what I mean? Like, getting back up from here to there.
Yeah, you can. I know you can. Okay. I have done it. Like, you see that ledge across the way? There's a way up here.
So many ways.
Yeah, you just walk up that tree root. Like that guy's doing.
Alright.
See, that guy's demonstrating. What a friendly hollow soldier. Yeah, it's only on different levels that the damage, that the hitboxes get a bit weird. Now, don't fall off. That was my mistake. I forgot fall off.
Don't drop off major cliffs. Alright, so how do we get back up? Because there's an item up there I wouldn't mind getting.
You will just walk up. I know there isn't an item up there. And here we are, still at the place we were just then, on a bridge thing.
Yeah.
Now no one will ever know that we lost the last 20 minutes of the audio and had to redo it.
I don't think you missed anything fucking thrilling, but now I get to...
Yes, now you get to go in this tunnel.
Yeah, and I got surprised by this douchebag and thought I'd locked on, but hadn't locked on, so I turned around as opposed to walking backward, which is exactly what you don't want to have happen. So I start using my little life lemons.
You mean you are currently using your life lemons, because this is still going on at this very moment.
This is in real time. I wonder where that guy's going.
Why don't you run up those stairs, Gabriel?
Yeah, totally.
I think that guy... I guess he's
slowest arrows.
I guess that guy's hurrying to meet the...
Edge slowly through the atmosphere like treacle.
January sales or something.
I wonder if those guys get anything for killing me. Like, they're like, I got some more humanity.
Yeah, probably. But they'd only squander it.
Yeah, I'd piss it away. I don't level up like
I
do.
Not like us, investing it in bath mats.
Grenade!
That's a pretty slow grenade, actually. That grenade's going, come on, come on.
And then...
You're gonna be in so much trouble when I get
over
there.
This is the item I came for, which is a shield, which is shitty.
A shitty-ass shield, and then you've noticed that archer over there.
Still firing at me.
Trying to repurpose your back as a mug tree.
And then here's where I think we discover that I can climb at speed. No, this is
no,
where
we, no, we didn't. You didn't know that.
Yeah, this is where I you yelled to, at me about
I
climbing
I had to
at
point
speed.
It out to you. Said, you can climb fast now. I showed you earlier, but you never pay attention.
Just exploring some shield just differences check, there.
Just checking out that buckler, which is shittier than our current shield.
Yoink. Those look like little lemons. Squish.
I'm gonna make myself some
guys are already dead.
Lemonade.
I'm pretty sure. Is this before I fought the turtle dudes? No, it isn't.
See, they say we're undead. We've actually just eaten so many lemons. We've gone all pucker-faced.
Try one. I don't want to look like that.
Tough. Now eat your lemons.
Eat your lemons.
This is a pucker-faced household.
Dog pucker-face.
It's... yes.
Tell by my face.
Who's Troy? Is that Douglas Uppity's boss? he read a management training book that suggested getting all your staff to eat lemons.
Yeah, because
it makes them more trustworthy for like from like the purchaser's point of view.
Staff unity.
Saying this guy's like sucking his entire lips inside his mouth. Mm. I like that in a person. Yeah. I will trust the things he says.
That just clearly, screams honesty.
Clearly, he has nothing to hide except his lips.
This is where I'm doing that Dark Souls thing of fighting and forgetting about the six.
Yes, yes. Dark Souls is a one-on-one fighter. Any more than that, and it becomes Hard Souls.
Yeah. Because even the bosses, if you've got a clean, you know, understanding of their pattern, they're you know, fairly easy. But bosses plus some goons, yeah, you've got an issue.
Yeah.
And it's always the goon hordes I had a bigger difficulty with in one than...
Yeah, it's the rule with... Dark Souls, clear out the minions first, if there are any.
Fucking minions.
Because they're the ones that will take you by surprise.
And everything hurts in this.
I mean, there's one boss fight that springs to mind in this game that's just a bunch of minions.
And then we freak out and realize that I've been battering around this soldier sword a bit.
Yeah, I was just noticed.
Swap it out.
Yeah. Those like pickup swords you get from enemies tend to be pretty shitty on the degradation front.
I decide not to go down there because it just looks like fire.
Yeah.
And then I realize this is not a statue.
No, that is a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle.
Yeah.
I think it's Donatello, if memory serves. He's the one who used...
Given that it is in Dark Souls, it might be a bit of a later artist.
He's the one who used a big stick.
Maybe Magritte.
This is the gritty Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles from earlier in the comic book.
Adult Mutant Ninja Turtles! Rawr. I'm just here to kill.
I glued a dustbin to myself. And then I put a smaller one on the end of my stick. Yeah, your sword's a little bit shorter than you think it is, isn't it, Gabriel?
Well, I keep going for the lunge. Like, I'm going for the dive, and it just doesn't activate, so I just get poke, which I know is
It's not a great follow-through to a lunge. Lunge is sort of supposed to be the end of the conversation.
I find it's good stick and move with big slowbows, though. Like, here, you know, look at him, he's just like, womp. Well, that's it. I've done my attack for the day.
Turtle guards, what is this? Mario?
Koopalings. We have Koopalings in Dark Souls.
And we picked up some really fucking heavy gloves.
Fuck yeah.
You want to put on because you're a big tanky bastard.
Hey man, it's, you know.
And I was wondering if we're getting the fat roll yet. Because we're at 66.2% load at present.
I'll probably tone it down because I've had to discover through... bitter experience. The game does not like you if you have fat roll.
Yeah.
Because there are just things that really, you can't guard.
Unless you've got really, really high defense and good armor.
Yeah, which I generally go for, but even then, if like in the DLC, like Usal Sanctuary in one.
Yeah, like if you're rocking Havel's armor.
I have Havel's armor. I have a great shield.
You got Havel's ring?
Yeah, I got it. Well, you need Havel's ring if you're going to have the armor.
Of course you got Havel's
ring. And there are these huge fucking stone cunts that do this one big boomy knocker attack. You can't stagger them, so it's the attack's happening. And you can't block the fucking thing. It knocks you down.
I've had trouble with stone cunts in my time.
I'm Cynthia Q Stonecunt.
Was this barricade for keeping something in?
Yeah,
or something
I
out?
Got really paranoid getting close to that because I expected it to just explode and some giant thing to come wandering out.
Well, reasonable, but
apparently this is the fire that doesn't hurt.
This isn't the part of the game where that happens. Meaning that
it's going
course,
to happen. There's me shitting the myself.
Yes, because we stumbled upon a giant fiery man.
Some kind of flame ball salamander.
I hate doing. post-commentary for this sort of thing. It sounds like we're showing someone our holiday snaps. And here we are outside the cave of the fiery thing. Here's Gabriel being a total tard and trying to run straight up to it.
I thought that was, you know, just because there's a giant evil monster down there shooting fire at me doesn't mean that's not where I'm supposed to go in any of these games.
Well, fair enough.
And then I discover this. And Yahtzee said, yeah, go in for a backslash.
Yeah, that's what I did. I said, hey, maybe give him a backstab. Get a bit ahead. Ha ha, you fell for it. I wanted my turn. See, that's the advantage I have, being familiar with the game.
You dickbag. And then this guy
dying
nearly
often enough for my taste.
I guess
we should amend the rules. And maybe...
Ow.
Every time we die or go back to Majula, we swap players. How about that?
I think keeping it to death, but I think maybe encouraging slightly more risk-taking play.
Okay. Well...
Because I won't play this like I'd normally play Dark Souls at home, which is rather poke around, look conservative, because...
Well, does anyone play Dark Souls liberally?
I will now. I'm just going to be like, yeah, fuck it. You know, up it for the rent. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
I mean, I've come to some good successes in Dark Souls by just playing that way. I mean, I don't even know what Gravelord Nido looks like. I beat him that fast.
Neato. He's neat. Oh.
Neaterific.
You know, I like the Pokemon.
Yeah. Nidoqueen. Yeah, I didn't even know what he looked like. I just ran in and just batted him with my fucking big weapon and that was over. And I was like, oh.
I think a lot of people who've walked right up to him don't know what he looks like. Because he's just a big blob.
Writhing pile of skeletons.
Well, it depends when you go after him in Dark Souls.
It was quite late for me. Yeah,
there's a tendency to go after him quite late in the game and it's quite easy to be overleveled.
Because the caverns are such a dickish place.
Yeah.
You just think, oh, I don't have the item that's meant to make me see down here.
And you forget about them, so you're like, where are all the places I've left for later? Well, there's the Duke's Archives, there's the Crystal Cave, the really cool-looking places. I think that's it. Oh, wait, also there was that really dark, dingy, uninviting place I didn't want to go to.
A place that does not look remotely where I should go.
Oh, and also...
And you don't get the little skull land for ages.
And Lost Izalith.
No, yeah.
Tell you what happened last time I was playing Dark Souls 1. I was playing through it. I decided I was going to do a run where I would save Solaire. And to do that, you have
That's really hard, apparently.
Yeah, you have to go into the Servants of Chaos Covenant and give enough humanity to the lady, the spider lady, that you get the level of the... in that covenant, that you can open up the door that leads to the place where all the insects are. Where Solaire will be later in the game, possessed and trying to kill you. So if you kill all the insects in that room at that point,
he's fine.
Then later on, Solaire won't be possessed and will be fine. So I did that, and then having done that, you can actually summon Solaire for the final boss fight. And I don't really need to, because Lord Gwyn's a fucking pussy. But I thought, you know, because we put all the work in, and because it's good for lore... And
come on
stuff.
Back, champ.
If you buy into the theory that Solaire is the lost son of Lord Gwyn, then I thought, let's do it. Let's sunbro it up for the final climax of the game. So I summoned him
Jolly cooperation.
In the area outside Lord Gwyn's boss fight. You know what happened then? Solaire dropped straight off ledge and died.
Fucking glorious.
I was like,
and thus ends the saga of Solaire.
I was like, well, that was anticlimactic, Solaire. Well done. Well fucking done, son, bro.
Edges.
Thanks. Well, gotcha. Thanks for making it all worth it.
Whee!
All that humanity I shoved in the spider lady's face.
Yeah, because how much is that?
Something like 25.
That's a lot.
It's quite a lot of humanity, true.
And I knew that this thing on the ground here was a fucking jerk, and I tried to hit him and just...
Yeah, fair enough that you'd think a thing like that.
As I can tell, things that are part of the goddamn active, you know, sprite count and art.
But here's a guy with a halberd.
Missed my fucking backstab because I wasn't exactly behind him.
He's saying, I got a halberd, Gabriel, you jelly.
Yeah, I am. I like the halberds. They're a good range because you see, I like my little poke and run away. Because that's especially if you're heavy and you don't have the roll factor.
Yeah.
Generally, you can get away with stick and move with like a really, this was great.
Yeah, so
I went with this guy a lot. Huh. And yes. Off he went.
That guy just needs to look at his analog stick.
Yeah. Use some health. Ran off the edge. And then he's gotten up.
Yep, he's gotten up. Ready for fun.
Moderately offended.
He was like, oh, sorry, were you trying to get my attention earlier?
Yes.
Here I am.
Tried to smack you with a sword, you fucking load.
I was saying something, but I forgot what it was.
Pants.
Well, it can't have been that important then.
Picking up more knickknacks. There's another finding thing. More dudes just yeah. waking up for their morning.
I remember what I said at this point. I said, yeah, I don't think you can backstab people before they finish their getting up animation.
And that's locked, because it's all locked.
Everything's locked. I think Dark Souls 2...
That's me deciding not to jump down there.
Dark Souls 2 really does sort of funnel you down the right path for the first bit.
There's definitely a lot more locked doors.
Yes.
At least in the opening game. I mean, you'd find them late, but...
yeah, and...
helpful. This time...
Yeah, we're not being fooled by that guy on all fours waiting for a DP there.
Yeah, he's just bent over. Like,
D.
I want to receive.
That was just a single P. I like how he sort of does the open door animation for a bit before realizing the door's not coming with him. Like, hey, usually there'd be a creaking sound and my hand would feel like some sort of resistance was
preventing its
movement.
A guy with a better sword than me falling for the fucking hunched over dude.
Yep. Dumbass.
Dickhead. Yeah, fucking dipshit.
And
Land of the jerks with bows.
Yes, here we are at Butlin's holiday camp.
And the usual routine of trying to figure out how I can get down into the explorer area before I go along dealing with the Ninja Turtles up there.
Yeah, I said, like, deal with the Ninja Turtles for progress, but there's some stuff to find in this area first.
Honestly, I'm not sure what you're doing if you're just hooning through the game, because you're obviously doing some kind
of
weird
run. Well, you're doing
it
wrong is what you're doing.
Yeah, because I just don't know how you're going to have the levels and general shit to deal with.
Because as we'll find as we explore this area, you there's quite a vital item here that you need.
And I was thinking of just jumping down there onto the ground to the right.
No, bad, Gabriel. Stop. Don't do that.
Yeah, I took a swig of some good old Estus.
Yeah.
And then Yahtzee suggests we hop off there to the left.
Yeah, down into that little room where the guy came out.
I tell you, the rules of what you can stand on and can't stand on in the Dark Souls are...
Do you remember Descending the Great Hollow?
Yes.
What fun that was. I wanted to make that a game when I was doing on Civil War with Jim Sterling.
Who can get to the bottom fastest?
Yeah, who can get to the bottom fastest without dying a stupid splatter death.
That would have been a good one.
But he didn't really have a save close enough to that area.
And that's work.
So the challenge we did do in Dark Souls, listeners, if you never saw that video, was we just we both picked deprived builds and challenged each other to try to break all the pots in the Asylum Demon starting area at the very beginning of the game. Don't fight the Asylum Demon, just try to break all the pots in the room, because there's a fuckload of pots.
Here's me not getting the lock on.
And I'm pleased to announce that I won that competition through pot breakage. All the previous rounds had been won through death of other player. But I won the last round through pot breakage. It was a nail biter.
Actual skill. Actual skill execution.
I think that was one of our best episodes for pure drama.
It was a good competition, because you've got the, you know, the wild card of the Asylum Demon. Kind of being a jerk. And here's me trying to pan around, which, you know, he's got a big arc, so that wasn't happening.
Yeah, I thought it was a good challenge. I think my other favorite challenge was playing and competing to see who could open their parachute last and not die.
And me not falling off the edge like a tit.
I won most of those rounds on a Jim Sterling splatter event. Tee-hee.
Titter chortle. And just having a bit of an explore. Ow, copping an arrow.
Yep, because this is where range combat would come in handy, wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, but I think...
Mr. Melee.
Focusing on ranges.
Well, you don't focus on range, you just have something for situations such as that.
Don't you have to have reasonably high dexterity before you can even use a fucking bow?
Depends on the bow. Some of them are strength focused. And... also, you could just get the basic fireball.
Oh, so satisfying.
Because pyromancy doesn't require stats.
Here I come.
It just requires a pyromancy flame. I mean, who wouldn't get pyromancy? You, apparently, you dumb twat.
I think, no, like, I did get it in Dark Souls 1, and I upgraded a bunch, and it just never did any damage, and...
Well, of course it didn't. You probably didn't upgrade your pyromancy hand enough.
I think it was...
And also, some enemies are weaker to it than others. You gotta use it against the right enemies.
The right kind of people.
Yeah, like, you know those slimes in the depths that drop from the ceiling? Really, really vulnerable to fire. Very, very strong against, like, physical attack. Very, very vulnerable to fire. So if nothing else, you want a fireball for that bit.
I remember. And here's me going, okay, I see the blood stains. What's hap?
Yeah, this was also me hoping Gabriel will die, because I didn't tell him about that. I was like, yeah, go right ahead, man. Put up your shield, you'll be fine. And go right in this cave. There's something we need in it. It's a cool place where all the cool kids hang out.
So, as you can probably imagine, I'm not listening to Yahtzee anymore.
Yeah. I was also secretly hoping he would get killed by an archer.
This is just, yeah, I wonder what's down here.
I guess those bloodstains tell you everything you need to know, huh? I mean, even putting the pit there was just blatant trolling on the designer's part,
that's,
I think.
That's what I love about Dark Souls, the game hates you.
Yeah, trolly foldy roll.
From software. Bunch of jerks.
From hell software.
Go talk to that guy, Yahtzee says. Ow! Still didn't kill me. And then he grumbled about how much of a tank I am.
He would have done if we didn't have such a tanky build.
I am a muscle nugget.
I'm a fucking sliver there.
Oh, yeah, that's not even a pixel.
I forgot to mention, you lose maximum health every time you die in this game.
Oh.
You see our health bar?
Yeah, there's another
one. It's got a little chunk missing on the end.
See, how do we fix that?
You turn human. Turn human and you get it all back. But there's a ring you can get in like the next major area of the game, which limits the health reduction to 75% rather than 50%, which is the default.
Hmm.
And I basically use that for the whole game. Because I was too used to Dark Souls, where you spend most of it hollow. Because you just die all the time.
It's a major part of the game mechanic of how you explore, is to run in, die, see what's there, or maybe grab anything if you can find it.
And here's an absent-minded fellow. I think your hair is numbing his brain.
Hello.
This is a case of seemingly shitty character who doesn't do anything, provides something only if you talk to him several times.
That's pretty much, there's been two characters like that now, so that's pretty much the clue, is just talk to them heaps until they finally go quiet.
He gives you the key to the mansion in Majula, which is a kind of important place. Although I don't think you actually have to go in there.
What is it? Well, I mean,
I'm trying to remember.
The voluntary areas, though, that's where you get the stuff. Like, I'm not going to not go to the area just so
I know
don't have
for a
to.
Fact there's an Estus flask shard in Majula House.
Oh, well, yeah.
Which is handy.
Got to get that.
Hey, you didn't pick up that thing. There was a pickup there you didn't pick up. Browsing your phone while we're recording?
Well, yeah, because we just went through this bit.
They don't do that at BBC Radio.
That's it. It's finished.
Oh, yeah. Well, I guess that will have to be our stop point. Because this is the point I remember when I realized we weren't recording.
Episode 1 in the 1,000 episode series of Let's Complete.
Oh, for sure. I can usually get through this game in like 80 hours.
That's radical.
80 videos.
Yeah, so we'll be finishing this around.
This one's an hour and a half anyway, so less than that.
All right, so probably about a year.
All right, well, I hope...
Be on this for a year.
All those people who said, play Dark Souls, appreciate this.
So help me God, if any of you miserable cunts grumble about how much Dark Souls we're playing, I'm going to personally mail you a small jar of turd.
Yes, and you'll get one from me if you complain about the 30 FPS.
Oh, so much.
And mine will be an extra stinky one.
It will fucking
I'm going to have tandoori beef beforehand, just for you.
Rip it raw.
See you next week in the ongoing... Well, not next week. I'll probably do Poacher next week.
The see Forever you next, series.
See you next time in the ongoing adventures of Douglas Upperty.
And his enormous schnoz.
Traveling toilet mat salesman with a dark past. See you next time.
Toodles.